Welcome to another FAR walkthrough video. I'm Logan, and in today's video, we're going to be going over items classified as other comprehensive income, or OCI. And we're going to be doing that the SuperfastCPA way, which is diving straight into questions to learn the material. If you don't know much about our strategies, make sure you go to superfastcpa.com and check out our free one-hour webinar training. We go over the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam, and again, it is free, it is only 1 hour long, and we will teach you how to be effective and efficient with your studying so you don't waste months or even years of your time. The link will be in the description, so make sure to check that out. Also, just letting you know, we will only be going over 5 questions in this video, whereas SuperfastCPA members will have access to the full 10-question video when we post it in the members forum. So, if you like this, you can get more of it by becoming a SuperfastCPA member. With all that said, let's dive straight into the questions. All right, here we are at question 1, and something I just want to say before we dive in, this is a fairly straightforward topic. It's a remembering and understanding topic on the blueprints, so not really much calculation here. It's more about understanding what is classified as other comprehensive income. So let's go to question 1. Which of the following items is included in accumulated other comprehensive income, or AOCI? And by the way, that's connected to OCI. We'll talk about that a little bit. But yeah, which one of these is included in other comprehensive income? If you don't know, that's okay. Kind of the idea behind the SuperfastCPA strategy is using the questions to learn how to do it. So let's go ahead and dive straight into the answer to start learning. All right, here we are. The answer is B, foreign currency translation adjustments related to a foreign subsidiary. So let's kind of dive into this. So the reason that that's correct, foreign currency translation adjustments arise when consolidating the financial statements of a foreign subsidiary into the parent company's financial statements. And a foreign translation adjustment, by the way, is if you have a foreign entity that's a subsidiary and they do their stuff in one currency, you have to translate that into the currency of the parent company, you know, let's say dollars in this case. So you would have to translate it, let's say, from euros to dollars, something like that. These adjustments are included in AOCI until the investment in the foreign entity is sold or liquidated. And I'll say this right now, AOCI, accumulated other comprehensive income, is basically the accumulation of other comprehensive income over time. So if you ever see that, accumulated other comprehensive income and other comprehensive income, they're related. Other comprehensive income is in the current year. Now let's go to option A. The reason that that's wrong is unrealized holding gains on trading securities are recognized in net income, not in other comprehensive income. These gains are considered part of regular earnings and are reflected in the income statement. Interest income, and this one would have been obvious, interest income on municipal bonds is recognized in net income, not in AOCI. It is part of the regular earnings reported on the income statement. And then obviously dividend income, that's included in net income. So the only thing here that is part of other comprehensive income is that foreign currency translation adjustment related to a foreign subsidiary. So foreign currency translations, that is one of the things that's included in other comprehensive income. Let's go to the next question to learn some more items like that. All right, here we are at question 2. Which of the following unrealized holding gains and losses would be included in accumulated other comprehensive income? All right, so which of these unrealized holding gains is included in other comprehensive income? If you don't know, that's okay. Again, we're learning this as we go. So let's go ahead and look at the answer together. All right, the answer is B, unrealized holding gains on available for sale debt securities. So this is another thing that is counted in other comprehensive income. Unrealized holding gains and losses on available for sale, or AFS, debt securities are included in AOCI. These gains and losses are not recognized in net income until the securities are sold. So the other things, unrealized holding gains on trading securities and held to maturity debt and equity securities, all of these things are not included in other comprehensive income. We'll talk a little bit more about held to maturity debt securities in a second here, because there is a way that they can be involved where it does have an effect on other comprehensive income. But again, we'll talk about that in another question. But again, this is just another thing that is included in other comprehensive income, unrealized holding gains from available for sale debt securities. Let's go to the next question. Okay, here we are at question 3. Company XYZ holds a portfolio of debt securities classified as held to maturity, or HTM. Due to a change in their investment strategy, they decide to reclassify some of these debt securities as available for sale. At the time of the transfer, the fair value of the reclassified securities exceeds their amortized cost by $50,000. How should this unrealized gain be reported? So again, it's saying that held to maturity securities were reclassified as available for sale debt securities. So there's an unrealized gain here. How does that work? Does that also affect other comprehensive income? We're not sure. If you want, go ahead and think about it and take a guess. If not, that's okay. We're just going to dive straight into the answer. All right, the answer is C, as an increase in accumulated other comprehensive income. Okay, you could probably guess that's the case just because that's what we're talking about in this video. But again, it's just another one of those things that you have to learn and kind of memorize to know which items are a part of other comprehensive income. So let's read this. C is the correct answer. When held to maturity, debt securities are transferred to available for sale securities. The unrealized gains or losses at the time of the transfer are reported in other comprehensive income and subsequently included in accumulated other comprehensive income. So the idea here is if you decide that these held to maturity are actually now going to be classified as available for sale, if there's a change in the value because of that and there's an unrealized gain from that, that can also be a part of other comprehensive income. But it's not going to be included in net income. We're not going to adjust the carrying value directly. And reducing the interest expense also isn't really related to it at all. So that's one more item that can be a part of other comprehensive income. Let's go to the next question. All right, here we are at question 4. Company ABC reports the following for the year. They have a net income of $500K, unrealized holding gains on available for sale debt securities of $30,000, deferred gain on the fair value hedge, $20,000, deferred gain on a cash flow hedge, $15,000, foreign currency translation adjustments, $25,000. So based on all this information and what we've learned so far, what of this is included in other comprehensive income for the year? Now, we haven't talked about hedges, so if you don't know anything about those, that's okay. We're going to talk about how those might affect this. But based on what you've learned so far, otherwise, you might be able to kind of guess at this. If you want, go ahead and pause the video and think about this. And when you're ready, come back. We'll look at the answer together. All right, the answer is $70,000. That's how much is going to be in other comprehensive income. So we only want to include the items that are supposed to go there. The unrealized holding gain on available for sale, that is something that can be included in other comprehensive income. So we include that, $30,000. Deferred gain on a cash flow hedge. So that's a new thing that we didn't know about. That is included in other comprehensive income. Foreign currency translation adjustments, we talked about that. That's included. We do not include the deferred gain on a fair value hedge, which was $20,000 in this case, since it is recognized in net income. So we learned two more things here. A cash flow hedge is included in other comprehensive income, whereas a fair value hedge is not. And we were reminded that available for sale debt securities and foreign currency translation adjustments can also be in other comprehensive income. So we learned another thing there. That all adds up, $30,000 plus $15,000 plus $25,000 to be $70,000. And with that, let's go to the next question. All right, here we are at question 5. Greenfield Corp has elected to measure a certain financial liability at fair value. During the year, the fair value of this liability decreased by $40,000 due to a deterioration in the company's own credit risk. How should this change in fair value be reported? Okay, this is something completely different from the rest of the things. It's very specific. Is this going to be included in OCI? Probably. That's what we're learning in this video. So let's go ahead and just dive straight into the answer to learn what this even means. All right. And as you could probably guess, it's going to be a gain in the other comprehensive income, but let's read about it. Changes in the fair value of financial liabilities attributable to instrument-specific credit risk are reported in other comprehensive income. So there can be specific liabilities, such as bonds, where it's tracked at their fair value and it's affected by the credit risk of the company. This treatment ensures that changes related to the issuer's credit risk do not directly impact net income, providing a clearer picture of the company's financial performance. So this is a situation where they don't want their credit risk to affect their net income. So for specific liabilities, they are having this change so that it's a part of other comprehensive income. This is a little bit confusing and something that might not come up too much on the CPA exam, but it is something that you might need to know. So I just wanted to point it out. This is one more situation where it would be included in other comprehensive income. Again, specifically for financial liabilities that are instrument specific for credit risk. So you purposefully do this. There's not too much more to know about it than that. And if you want to dive more into it, you can in another way. But I just wanted to throw it out there in this question. That's something that you need to know for the CPA exam. And with that, we've learned a lot with just 5 questions. Before we go any further, we're going to do one more part of the process called pillar topics. Now, the idea behind pillar topics is as you're going through the questions to learn the material, you will notice the things that keep popping up, the things that it's trying to teach you. Okay, these items are obviously in other comprehensive income. These items are obviously not. And you kind of take note of that as you're going, and eventually you write down pillar topics, the things that are most important, so that you know what you need to know for exam day. So let's go ahead and look at pillar topics for this video. All right, here we are at the pillar topics. We're just going to dive straight into it. Unrealized holding gains and losses on available for sale debt securities are included in other comprehensive income until they are realized through sale or settlement. Foreign currency translation adjustments arising from consolidating a foreign subsidiary's financial statements into the parent company's financial statements are included in OCI as well until the investment in the foreign entity is sold or liquidated. Gains and losses on derivative instruments designated as and qualifying for cash flow hedges are reported in OCI and reclassified into earnings in the same period or periods during which the hedged forecasted transaction affects earnings. Next, unrealized gains and losses resulting from the transfer of debt securities from held to maturity to available for sale are included in OCI, reflecting changes in the fair value at the time of the transfer. And then finally, changes in the fair value of financial liabilities attributable to the instrument-specific credit risk are recognized in OCI. So overall, just remember, unrealized holding gains and losses for available for sale debt securities, foreign currency translation adjustments, gains and losses on cash flow hedges, unrealized gains and losses from transfer of held to maturity to available for sale security, and then finally, financial liabilities attributable to the instrument-specific credit risk. So those are the main things that you need to know that are included in other comprehensive income. And that is it for this video. Before you go, make sure to check out our free one-hour webinar training on superfastcpa.com. Again, we teach you the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam so that you don't waste any time. It is only 1 hour and it is free, so make sure you go check that out. Also, we only went over 5 questions in this video, but just remember that Superfast CPA members will have access to the full 10-question video when we post it in the members forum. So if you like this, you can get more of it by becoming a Superfast CPA member. If you like the video, make sure to like it and leave a comment. I hope this was helpful, and I will see you in the next video.